Hi all, electrical engineer Igor Ekimov is with you again. Finally, it was time to install the voltage relay that I reviewed earlier. Four videos have already been recorded with this relay. You will find links to them in the description. And of course, subscribe to the channel and click on the bell so you don't miss new videos. The panel already contains a voltage relay, which I reviewed earlier. This is exactly the voltage relay that is not worth buying. At the moment, the apartment is not powered through it. As you can see, the voltage relay outputs are disabled. I will remove this voltage relay and install a new voltage relay. You will also find a link to a review of the old relay in the description. We check which input of the voltage relay the phase goes to. You see, the phase comes here, and here, accordingly, 0. We remember this location of the pins. We have phase on the white wires, and 0 on the black wires. If your wires are the same, then mark the phase wires with electrical tape. Why is this fundamentally important? Most voltage relays only disconnect one pole. The phase must be switched off. And the 0 input and output inside the voltage relay are simply shorted. There is a marking on the voltage relay. L is phase. N is 0. The connection of these wires cannot be mixed up. Otherwise, the voltage relay seems to be working, but it will turn off 0. And as a result, all the wiring in the apartment will be out of phase. Turn off the input machine. Check that there is no voltage at the voltage relay terminals. We don't have a phase here. Accordingly, there is no phase here either. I warn you that you need to check the absence of a phase with a previously tested screwdriver. We checked it before the power outage. A disconnected electricity meter also tells us that there is no phase. Dismantling and installation of the voltage relay must be done carefully, so as not to break the seals on the input machine and on the meter. If you damage it, the problems can be serious. Unscrew the input terminals of the voltage relay. Unscrewed the phase wires. And unscrewed the neutral wires. We pry the eyelet from the bottom of the voltage relay. And the voltage relay is removed. We move the wires away so that they do not interfere with us. We put the upper part of the voltage relay on the DIN rail. And then we press on it and snap it into place. The voltage relay has been installed, now we will connect it. Please note, on this voltage relay, the phase terminals and 0 terminals are located differently. So you can't just change one voltage relay to another. Always look at the markings. We connect the neutral wire to terminal N. The phase wire to terminal L. Screw it on. Now we connect the wires that fit our output machine. The voltage relay output L is indicated here. We connect the phase wire to terminal L. We connect the neutral wire to terminal N. If you are not experienced, you can insert the wire past the clamping part of the terminal. It looks like the terminal has been tightened, but the wire itself is not clamped. We check the terminals by lightly tugging the wires. All wires were checked. They don't stretch. That is, we clamped the wires well. If the wire were not clamped, it would easily come out of the terminal. Connect the voltage. Our voltage relay starts counting down 10 seconds. Here we have the voltage turned on. We check with an indicator screwdriver that our phase voltage is at terminal L. Everything is fine. At terminal L we have a phase. Here is the entrance, and here is the exit. Also at the output of the output switch. On the white wire we have a phase. Here is the entrance. Here is the exit. If the wires are not connected correctly, the switches will not work correctly. They will interrupt not the phase, but the 0. And God forbid, you did a protective grounding in the socket. Then there will be a phase on the device body. So, check this carefully. It is prohibited to make protective grounding inside the socket. As we can see, this voltage relay shows an input voltage of 230 volts. And shows that we currently have a current draw of 400 milliamps or 0.4 amps. This relay has already been programmed. I will leave my settings for this relay in the description. Why I set these settings and how to program this relay I discussed in a separate video. There is also a video in which this relay was tested. If you have the opportunity, be sure to test the voltage relay. When installed in a switchboard, it will not be possible to test it. Links to videos will be in the description. Now I'll go over the relay settings. A1. Now the circuit has one input machine and one output machine. The actual current through them is equal in magnitude. We select the setting according to the lowest rated current of the machine. This is a 16A output machine. When I add more machines to the output over time, I will configure the relay according to the rating of the input machine. I have it at 20 amperes, since it will already limit the total current of the output circuit breakers. The maximum current that this relay can be configured for is 40A. You can also purchase a 63A relay. I will leave a link to the store in the description. We check the presence of voltage in the apartment. If your sockets and lamps work, congratulate yourself. You have connected the voltage relay. I have prepared many more interesting topics for videos for you. Subscribe to the channel and press the bell so you don't miss them. In the comments, you can suggest your topics for the videos and your thoughts on the topic of the video. And also don't forget to like and repost. This will greatly help promote the video, and I will be grateful to you. See you in new videos.